we've been working with VR for about 3 years now. And we started working with various departments, including the education department, occupational therapy, and others. But this last fall, we started working with Professors Aberbeck and Sanghae Moon in the neuroanatomy class for physical therapy. And what we did is, since Aberbeck was in Brazil, we were able to find a software program that would allow his students to come in and use VR in an anatomy lab for their neuroanatomy class. We all met in a 3D space with a 3D model of the brain, and Dr. Beck was able to conduct class in that environment. So it really gave the students a sense of being together, learning together, and getting direct instruction in a 3D space from the professor.
I think what's so promising about virtual reality is that we found in many situations of reality, such as a pandemic, that there are going to be times where you can't connect with people you want to. And it's not just about abandoning all ways of having an emotional connection. We found ways to use technology to create those emotional connections when we were distanced from each other.
Students really seem to appreciate having multiple avenues in which to learn. Not everybody likes to read a book. Not everybody likes to sit in the library and study. Some people are very visual learners. Some people are very experiential learners. And that's what VR really brings to the table, is that you can put on a headset, you can be in an environment and do things in VR that you can't do outside of VR.
The best experience is when people take the headset off and I get to see them kind of reacclimate to the world. And they're like, oh, okay, this is where I am. Or, wow, I didn't even know I was at this part of the room. Because they really just lose connection with their physical body in some ways. And it's exciting because they've been taken out and given something new and exciting in a way that they haven't probably since kindergarten. That same novel experience of trying something completely brand new on and then having to think about how you could take that new thing and expand it.
This is really part of a larger initiative called the Center for Creative Technology. And it's a real effort to open up the creative tech arts to anybody on the IC campus, faculty, staff, students. If you want to come make something, if you want to experience VR, if you want to make a podcast, if you want to learn Photoshop, Illustrator, if you want to go 3D print something, we've got the staff here to help you do that.